Hello students, today I will throw some light on parametric and non-parametric tests. As we all know, in social sciences where direct knowledge of population parameters is rare, hypothesis testing is the often used strategy for generalization of population based upon sample data. Thus, we can also say that hypothesis testing helps us to decide on the basis of a sample data whether a hypothesis about the population is likely to be true or false. Testing of hypothesis can be classified as first, parametric test, which is also known as standard tests of hypothesis. And the second is non-parametric test, which is popularly known as distribution-free test of hypothesis also. These procedures are classified based on the measurement scale of the variables involved in the study. For parametric test, the variables should be measured at least on an interval scale. If you remember, scale on which the data is measured is of four types, that is nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio. Nominal being the lowest form of scale and ratio the highest scale in the same order. So here for parametric test, the variables have to be measured on interval or ratio scale. For non-parametric test, the variables have to be measured on nominal or ordinal scale. Now let us discuss the assumptions for parametric test. Parametric tests usually assume certain properties of the parent population from which the sample is drawn, such as population from where the sample is drawn is normally distributed. The sample size has to be large enough, and population parameters like mean, they are based upon population parameters like mean, variance, etc. Variables here should be measured on metric scale. We also know them as metric scale. Let us now see assumptions for non-parametric test. Unlike parametric test, non-parametric tests do not depend on any assumption about the parameters of their parent population. That is, population under study are not normally distributed. The data rather is extremely skewed. A data is said to be skewed when curve appears distorted or skewed either to the left or to the right side. Here the sample size is small. Variables are measured on non-metric scale. So nominal or ordinal scales are put under the category of non-metric scales. Now let us see the advantages for non-parametric tests. First is, they can be applied to many situations as they do not have rigid requirements as of their parametric counterparts, like the sample having been drawn from the population following a normal distribution. Next is, sometimes the researcher may encounter such situations where a numeric observation is difficult to obtain but a rank value is not. For example, it is easy to obtain the rank data on the preference of consumer for the various brands for toothpaste rather than assigning a numerical value to them. Next advantage is, non-parametric tests can often be applied to the nominal and ordinal data that lack exact or comparable numerical values. For example, the respondents may be asked a question on their religion, Hindu, Sikh, Christian or Muslim. This is a nominal scale data and can only be analyzed by non-parametric methods. Next is, non-parametric tests involve very simple computations compared to the corresponding parametric tests. However, The methods are not without their own drawbacks, and there are certain disadvantages of non-parametric tests. These are, first, a lot of information is wasted because the exact numerical data is reduced to a qualitative form. Here, no consideration is given to the quantity of the gain or the loss. Next is, non-parametric methods are less powerful than parametric tests. Next disadvantage is, null hypothesis in a non-parametric test is loosely defined as compared to the parametric tests. For example, in parametric tests, if null hypothesis is formulated as that the means of the two population are equal in the parametric test, in non-parametric test, the null hypothesis would be that the two populations have same probability distribution. In such a situation, rejecting a null hypothesis under the parametric test would imply that the means of the two populations are different, whereas under a non-parametric test, it means that the two population distributions are different, but the specific form of the difference between the two populations is not clearly defined. This slide presents the difference between parametric and non-parametric test. The first point is assumptions on which the differences are there. We have already discussed these assumptions. Let us go through them once again. In parametric tests, normality assumption is required, whereas in non-parametric test, it is not required. Parametric tests use metric data, that is interval or ratio data, whereas non-parametric tests uses non-metric data, that is nominal or ordinal data. Parametric tests can be applied for both small and large samples, but the non-parametric tests can be applied for small samples only. Talking about the applications part, in parametric test, one sample using Z or T statistic. In non-parametric test, one sample using the sign test. These are the applications, the tests. Next is two independent samples using a T or Z test. In non-parametric test, two independent samples are tested using the Mann-Whitney U statistics. In parametric test, two paired samples are tested using a T or Z test. Whereas in non-parametric test, two paired samples are tested using the sign test and Wilcoxon matched pair rank test. Next is several independent samples can be tested using F-test in ANOVA for parametric test. In non-parametric test, several independent samples using Kriskal-Wallis test can be used. This slide clearly presents the different tests that can be categorized under parametric and non-parametric test. As we can see, as we have already discussed, parametric tests are based on metric data, that is interval and ratio. For one sample test, there are T-tests, Z-tests. For two samples, it can be for independent samples, two-group T-test is used and Z-test is used. For paired samples, paired T-test is used. For non-parametric test, as we have again discussed, that it is based upon non-metric data, that is nominal and ordinal. It can be classified under two heads, one sample test and two sample test. For one sample test, we can use chi-square, KS test, runs, binomial. For two sample test, it can be further categorized into independent samples and paired samples. For independent samples, again, we can use chi-square test, Mann-Whitney, median and KS. For paired samples, sign test, Wilcoxon, McNamara and chi-square test can be used. In this, we have already discussed the chi-square test. In further videos, we'll be talking about the parametric tests, the different types of tests falling under parametric tests. For any query, feel free to comment below. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.